So that was the law, and we brought you the order. We've raced through 50 years of cop shows and counted down 49 of TV's greatest detectives.
I chose you, Jeff. You're the one. Thanks.
But if it isn't any of them, who have you voted for as top of the cops? Forget who done it. Let's find out who won it.
I rest my case.
The truth is, Americans write better cop show theme tunes. Pretty much across the board, with one exception, and that is The Professionals. And when it starts, ding-ding-ding, okay, Shaft, you can go. Starsky and Hutch, you can go. Listen to this.
It's like a clarion call for what's going to happen for the next hour. It's going to be 52 minutes of mayhem.
Brian Tesler came to me, an executive of LWT, and he said, Starsky and Hutch is very popular. We'd like a buddy series.
After you?
No, please.
And the rest is history, really.
Professionals comes from the team that brought us the Avengers. It's probably the next logical step. After the fantasy of the Avengers, they turned to the more realistic world of counter-terrorism. Bodie and Doyle are the double act at the centre of the Professionals. Two very different characters put together to form a team.
Doyle.
CI5.
That's Bodie.
Auto CI5.
Doyle was the slightly softer of the two who didn't necessarily want to go straight to violence, while Bodie, the brooding former SAS officer, always had his hand on the trigger, ready to kill.
Bodie and Doyle became one of television's greatest on-screen partnerships, but it could have all been very different.
Originally, Anthony Andrews was slated to play Bodie. But when they filmed him with Martin Shaw, apparently there was no on-screen chemistry.
There was not that magic of, you know, flint striking stone. So reluctantly, very reluctantly, we told Anthony that it wasn't going to work, and we paid him off and started looking again.
Where's Woody?
So Andrews got the boot, and they brought in a guy who was relatively unknown then, Lewis Collins, you know, and that worked a treat.
The great skill in putting those two boys together was that you had, in Lewis Collins, you had a personality actor, and you had Martin, who'd come out of the RSC playing gritty roles.
Woody, Doyle.
There was something really magical that happened on screen, because they fired off each other in a brilliant way.
Man just fell out of a seven-story window.
That's police business.
He jumped.
That's his business.
You'd see Martin working to find the reality in a scene, and Lewis, because he was the personality actor, he could take a scene just by lifting an eyebrow.
Somebody had slipped him a drug, him and half the staff there.
Well, that's drug squad
drug
business.
Drug squad business.
What are you two, some kind of music hall act?
Whatever we are, you made us.
The Cops series till then were all sort of a bit plod. But I wanted, I wasn't interested in doing plod.
Plod definitely wasn't a word that you could use to describe CI5's finest.
Two dead, neither of them us, we did okay.
When it came to action sequences, Bodie and Doyle didn't just raise the bar, they smashed it to smithereens.
Whose turn is it?
Yours.
Because we sent them on training courses, they looked good with guns. You believed that they knew how to use them, because they did know how to use them.
I hope you've got licenses for those guns of yours.
In 1983, the Professionals called it a day.
We're on our way. Goodbye.
But free of the shackles of CI5, Martin Shaw reportedly lost affection for the show, blocking repeats for several years. But that didn't stop generations of new fans finding out for themselves what makes it your Top of the Cops.
The Professionals are still cult TV, I think, because it's a cool show. It was cool then, it's cooler now. Somewhere in the world, it's always being shown. And that in itself is a kind of accolade.
Pum, tiddly, pum, 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 pum.